so here we have three examples. And let's do the first one, all right? Convert 3,000 grams to kilograms. So first, acknowledge what you're given. You're given 3,000 grams. So you're gonna write 3,000 grams. And you wanna go to kilograms. So you're gonna multiply by the conversion factor. We want kilograms, let's put that on top. We have to cancel out grams. Let's put that on the bottom. So we have to remember the conversion from grams to kilograms. Kilograms is big, we're talking about big stuff. And so 1 kilogram is 10 to the 3 grams. And so you write that relationship here. And so we see that grams cancel and we're left with kilograms. And so you put these numbers in your calculator, you get 3 kilograms. So that's number one. One step conversion from something from the base to something big. Number two, we're going from big to the base. Right, and so what are we given? We're given 0.5 megagrams, because it's a capital M, it's megagrams. So write down what you're given, 0.5 megagrams. I'm gonna multiply by the conversion factor. I want grams, that'll go on top. I wanna get rid of megagrams, that'll go on bottom. So we're talking mega, we're talking something big. So now you have to remember the conversion factor. 1 megagram is 10 to the 6 grams, because mega is 10 to the 6, just like how kilo was 10 to the 3. And so I write that here. Say 5 times 10 to the 5 grams. Those are equivalent. This is scientific notation. Right, so number three now is a tricky one. Go from micrograms, which is small, to kilograms, which is big. We don't have a connection between these two. Alright, so let's write down all the connections that we have. We know micrograms is small, right? So 1 microgram is 10 to the negative 6 grams. We know kilograms is big, so 1 kilogram is 10 to the 3 grams. So these two aren't directly related, but they're both related to grams. So we're going to have to go from small to grams and then to big. So what I mean by that is it's no longer a one-step problem, it's a two-step problem. And so you need to be able to do these, right? So this is an example on how to do these. So first, acknowledge what you're given. You're given 8 times 10 to the 10 micrograms, right? And so I don't know the conversion from micro to kilo, but I know micro to gram, and I know gram to kilo. So let's do that. First, let's turn this into grams. So multiply by the conversion factor. I'm going to put micro on the bottom and grams on the top. see that micros cancel out. And so at this instance, I'm in grams. Let's convert grams to kilograms. Right, so I want to get rid of grams, so I'm going to put grams on the bottom. And move this out the way. And I'm going to write kilograms on the top. And we know the conversion is that 1 kilogram is 10 to the 3 grams. And then units of grams cancel out. And so when you plug this into your calculator, you'll get 80 kilograms. So that's how you would do a two-step problem. You would just multiply it twice. Make sure all your units cancel out and you're left with what you want. Right, so recap, acknowledge what you're given, multiply by your conversion factor, make sure your units cancel, and you're done. Right, so this is how you do these. We'll do some more complicated conversions in the